Exercises whose 500th year of conversion moment is commemorated and whose spirituality is very dear to the sisters of St. Charles Borromeo. Mary Immaculate Convent Shimoga invites you to journey today with St. Ignatius as we explore the glimpses of his early life, conversion moment, his contribution to the realm of spirituality, and personal insights and experiences of our sisters over the years.
Welcome you, dear sisters.
Inigo Lopez de Loyola was born in 1491 in the castle of Loyola, Spain. He was youngest of the 13 children. At a very tender age, he lost his parents. He desired to become a courtier with required education and developed a taste for name and fame. He was a soldier at the young age of 18 years.
Ignatius, who belonged to the Spanish nobility, had high ambition to become a knight. He participated in the siege of Pamplona in 1521.
Pamplona is lost, Loyola.
I say we fight.
He was leading the Spanish troops in defense of Pamplona against the French attacking army. On May 28, 1521, a cannonball struck and severely wounded one of his legs. He wanted to win battles for his king and the heart of his lady love. He underwent many surgeries but still limped. This handicap shattered his worldly dreams. During this period of convalescence at the castle of Loyola, he read the books on the life of Christ and the life of saints. The cannonball movement was his moment of rude awakening to a spiritual conversion and a life oriented towards God's glory. Recuperating in 1522, Ignatius visited the shrine of Our Lady of Montserrat. Spending a day in prayer, he laid down his weapons and shed his armor and retreated to Manresa for solitude, prayer, and meditation. Ignatius' experience in Manresa on the banks of River Cardona was the most decisive influence on Ignatian spirituality.
Besides the founding of the Society of Jesus, the spiritual exercises formally accepted by Pope Paul III in the year 1548 are one of the distinctive and lasting contributions of St. Ignatius to the Church. Life of St. Charles Borromeo, written by Most Reverend Cesare Osligo, gives us some of the glimpses of emulation of Ignatian spirituality in the life of our patron, a contemporary of St. Ignatius of Loyola. St. Charles drew spiritual treasures from the spiritual exercises, namely contemplation, meditation, prayer, instruction, and examination of conscience. The chronicles of the congregation speaks of our founder and predecessors who have highly prized, deeply personalized, and greatly benefited from the Ignatian spirituality.
Today, we quickly take you through the lens of the present constitution emphasizing Ignatian spirituality. Article number 37. Inspired by Ignatian spirituality, the congregation provides for a minimum of definite daily times of prayer. Article number 34 reads, our prayer must be above all contemplation of Jesus. This contemplation lived out, especially in daily meditation, helps us to let ourselves be transformed by His Spirit and show forth in our life His love for the Father and His tenderness towards humanity. Article number 60. A sister of St. Charles is contemplative in her apostolate and apostolic in her contemplation.
The articles strongly emphasize the significance of contemplation. It's a form of imaginative prayer where we picture ourselves at the scene of the gospel with Jesus, allowing us to connect ourselves with who Jesus is and who we are before God.
Article number 32, about responsible obedience, our constitution invites us to be attentive to God's will, manifested by interior inspirations, signs of the times, events and circumstances, and discern it with our superior in openness to God and to the mission of the congregation.
Ignatius emphasized obedience as seeking and surrendering to the will of God to obtain a far superior vision of doing everything to the will of God. It would enable one to the experience of fulfillment and lasting satisfaction.
Article number 37. Examination of consciousness is discernment face to face with the Lord to discover His goodness and His invitations and to evaluate the generosity of our response.
Examine of consciousness is the legacy of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. It's a daily practice handed over to us by our predecessors.
Hence, Ignatian spirituality is a spirituality for everyday life, for the sisters of St. Charles Borromeo to find God in all things and all things in God. Let's now hear the first-hand lived experiences of Ignatian spirituality of our sisters.
I am happy to share with you my experience of daily examination of consciousness. This exercise gives me self-awareness and helps me daily to find God's presence in my life. I remember the day I spent, the love and support I have received. I thought of the people with whom I interact. I experienced the divine presence in the events of the day. A kind word from a friend, the nutritious food I relish, the energy and good health God has blessed me with. And thus, I review the day with gratitude and thank my God. At the same time, I also have become aware that some ways I fell short. I pay attention to my feelings. What is God telling me through my feelings? Feelings of frustration made me to realize that I need to be kind to myself and be willing to change. I acknowledge the time when I act sinfully and selfishly, and I begin to ask God's forgiveness and healing. I feel empowered by God's reassuring words in Psalm 103 verse 8. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, abounding in steadfast love. Great is your love for me, O Lord. I pray, Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. Bless me, God, with your love. Bless me with your healing. Bless me with your peace. As the days and years passed, I came to know more and more about one thing. Whatever we do, do it for the greater glory of God. Examination of consciousness helped me to acknowledge sad or painful feelings and learn how God is speaking through them. Above all, to be faithful to God. Yes, to be faithful to God, for He has called me and I belong to Him. God loves me unconditionally. His grace is enough for me. For He says, Elsie, don't be afraid, for I am with you always.
St. Charles says, action is valuable only when it has its source in contemplation. My daily contemplation is a time where I rest, reflect, and reconnect to my God. It helps me to be mindful in my actions that glorify God. In the initial years of my formation, I used meditative way of praying, and as the years passed by, there is a deeper thirst in me for contemplation of mysteries of Jesus Christ. My daily contemplation awakens me to be more loving, gentle, kind, compassionate, and helpful to the needy, and to deepen the awareness of myself and that of others. In contemplation, I personally experience the compassionate love of God.
As for me, discernment is the heart of Ignatian spirituality. Only action that is taken with respect to the interior movements has true discernment. After listening to the word of God, tradition and constitution, I discern the will of God. I ask myself, what is God's will in my situation? I take time, use my head and heart as my tools, values as my cornerstone, faith in God and inner freedom as my context. I identify the issue, examine the values, exercise indifference, take time to pray to the Holy Spirit, listen to His inspiration, and then make the decision. Discuss the decision with one I trust, dialogue with one affected by the decision, live out the decision with courage, hope and trust.
Discernment for me is nothing but choose with God. This gives me inner peace and a sense of satisfaction. Sometimes my own self-will, biases and attachments have withheld me from discerning properly the will of God in certain situations of my life. At times, I say yes to God, but fail to give expression to my words generously. In challenging and different situations, I lack the courage to be faithful to God's will in my life. I trust that Jesus leads me through life.
Sister Lydia, I have often heard you say, "Ad maiorem Dei gloria." What do you mean by that?
It means that all our actions magnify, honor, make known the beautiful, perfect, loving, and almighty nature of God. And therefore, to bring glory to God is to make Him known in my day-to-day events. However, God's glory is not dependent on me. God's glory never fades. I need to grow day by day towards this sublime end. As St. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31, "Whether you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do all for the glory of God."
That's what I receive from you. Sister Lydia, presence of God has been your very favorite concept. How did you develop this awareness?
While I was in formation, pre-Vatican period, caption "Presence of God" was placed in all our common rooms to bring home to us that God is dwelling in me, in us, in all that we do. And that is why we have imbibed that idea, the concept that God is dwelling in me. God is present everywhere.
Thank you for that sharing. Is there anyone you remember who lived this awareness of the presence of God?
I still remember how Mother St. John Kennedy put this thought in practice by recognizing the presence of God in the sisters she met by a gentle bow. And when we asked her, she told us that she is the temple of God and God dwells in her.
Thank you for sharing such spiritual treasures that our predecessors have imbibed. And it was nice listening to you as well. Thank you.
Ignatius Loyola was beatified by Pope Paul V in 1609 and canonized by Pope Gregory XV in 1622. In 1922, he was declared patron of all spiritual retreats by Pope Pius XI. Today, we express our gratitude to the colossal contribution of St. Ignatius of Loyola. His life teaches us to seek divine will and to frame everything around God rather than ourselves. His spiritual exercises help us to realize that all the externals are temporary and passing, and that only God is absolute and eternal. Let us seek His intercession on this spiritual journey as we make His prayer our own.
Take and receive, O Lord. Do
pray for us.